appreciate it. Thank you. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, Detective Jose Estevez. On behalf of the Police Commissioner, I'd like to welcome you to the Patrol Bronx Interfaith Prayer Service. It is now my great pleasure to introduce Pastor Raymond Rivera from Latino Pastoral Action Center.
I want to take this opportunity to welcome the Commissioner and Chief Jaffe and all of the other illustrious leaders of the police department, all of the rank and file that is here, also all of the pastors and imams and rabbis, and they represent different faiths, and we're here to pray and to reflect and to celebrate. We want to thank God this evening for the New York City Police Department. We're going to thank God because they protect us from crime. Come on, say amen.
Yeah.
They protect us from terrorism, and they protect our right to protest. Yes, yes, come on, come on.
Amen.
So we're excited for your service, and it's just so good to have all of the men and women in blue today. I feel protected. So we're just excited to have you, and we're in a time of great change in our political discourse. We're in a time of great turmoil and conflict, both in the city and in the nation, and this is the front line of protection for our city. So it's good that today is not going to be so much about policy and so much about politics, but it's going to, in the midst of all of this polarized atmosphere and division, we're all here from all faiths, all nationalities, several languages, and it's good to see a sign of hope once in a while.
Amen!
We're excited for this sign of hope, and we're excited for this unity service. So, again, welcome to the Latino Pastoral Action Center, this here in the urban ministry complex, several churches under my leadership congregate. We have after-school centers, youth programs, charter schools, alternatives to incarceration, re-entry programs, and we cooperate with our local police department in all of these programs. So again, welcome. Or talk to the person next to you and tell them welcome, welcome.
Yes, welcome. Thank you, Pastor. Ladies and gentlemen, to begin their reflections, please welcome Sheikh Musa Damed of the Fort City Mosque.
Thank you very much, and welcome to the Boogie Down Bronx. You know, crime is so low, the commissioner came by himself. Anyway, let us all say amen. We have one of the shortest prayer in Islam. Alhamdulillah, in the name of Allah, Rabbana Atina fi Dunya Hasana, wa fil Akhirati Hasana, wa Qina Adhaban-Nar. O God, give us the best in this life, and the best year after. I mean, thank you.
Thank you. I'd like to introduce Imam Sharif Faizula of Carchester Islamic Center.
وجعلناكم شعوبا وقبائل لتعارفوا إن أكرمكم عند الله أتقاكم.
In the Quran, Allah says, O people, we have created you from one man and one woman, Adam and Eve. And then we made you into nations and communities so that you may know one another. And the best amongst you is the one who is the most God-fearing. So we pray, O Allah, guide for us our youth, bring them to the truth, protect them from influences that would cause them to be misled, forgive our parents and grandparents and have mercy on our dead. Remove from us the overpowering of men and the overburdening of debt. Give us success, remove our stress, marry our bachelors and bachelorettes. Grant our students the ability to excel in all of their exams and studies. Free our innocent prisoners and bring them back to their families safe and secure. Heal our sick from all ailments. You alone are the one to cure. O Allah, we seek your protection from being tested and protection for our families and communities in this land. Protect us from all directions as people of belief. Replace for us courage for our fear, exhilaration for our grief. Have mercy on our diseased. Protect our sons and daughters.
ربنا هب لنا من أزواجنا وذرياتنا قرة أعين واجعلنا للمتقين إماما.
Our Lord, make our spouses and our children the coolness of our eyes. So when we see them, our heart is content and peaceful. And make us an example for those who are righteous and God-fearing. Amen.
Of the Fellowship Tabernacle.
I give the Lord a hand clap tonight. And as y'all just do me a favor, everybody just stand up. Just look at your neighbor right quick. Look at their blue eyes, brown eyes, green eyes, whatever color they have in tonight. They might be sleepy, might be red eyes. So just grab my hand and say, neighbor, we're better together. Come on, turn around and tell somebody else, say, we're better together.
We're better together.
Come on, put those hands together. Good Lord. Good to see you. We gather tonight together as one to recognize the significance of the unity in our community. As I've listened over the last few weeks to our Mayor de Blasio and our Police Commissioner Neil speak of the overall reduction in crime throughout the city, the continued hope of this decreasing trend, we say thank you to NYPD. Let's give them a hand clap. And foremost, we say thank you to our God, who is our righteous judge and our fair enforcer. We also acknowledge the working together of our police department and elected officials, with our community residents, our faith-based leaders, the business community, and other community-based organizations with grassroots efforts right here in Bronx County, such as Cure Violence Sites. I'm going to ask Jacoby Hospital, stand up to violence, stand up to that. Come on, give them a hand clap. Release the Press, Bronx Rise Against Gun Violence, and SOS, just to make a few that all working together as one. Bring this hope into manifestation. We are better together. It was King Solomon who penned in Ecclesiastes, the 4th chapter, two are better than one, because together they can work more effectively. If one of them falls down, the other can help him up. But if someone is alone and falls, it is just too bad because there is no one to help him. In essence, his message was simply, we're better together. We can examine togetherness from a biblical snapshot. We observe the lives of Adam and Eve, Abraham and Sarah, Moses and Joshua, Elijah and Elisha, David and Jonathan, Ruth and Boaz, Peter and John, Paul and Silas, and most importantly, Jesus and his disciples. They were the epitome of we're better together. I can remember growing up as a child that even some of our fictional characters, I know some of y'all might be a little young in the room, but they exemplified togetherness. The likes of Mickey Mouse had a Minnie Mouse. Underdog had a Sweet Polly. Courageous Cat had a Minute Mouse. Batman had a Robin. Green Hornet had a Kato. Superman even had an alter ego, Clark Kent. Even the Lone Ranger had a Tonto. They realized the significance of we're better together. So tonight, when we go back to our several homes and communities, let us continue to work together, to build together, and help others as we make our neighborhoods an even more safe and better place to live, to work, and to love.
Let's continue to have the village effort to heal our families and communities. Let's continue to be servants in our borough and throughout the city. Let's continue to be prayerful for our communities and its leaders, elected officials, and first responders. Prayerful for our country, domestic, national, and world peace. In this changing world, let us hold on to our unchanging faith, because we are better together. And so as I close, I believe the validity of the statement that everybody needs somebody sometime. And Joan Baez said it best when she sung the song, "No man is an island, no man stands alone. Each man's joy is joy to me, each man's grief is my own. We need one another, so I will defend each man as my brother, each man as my friend. No man is an island, way out in the blue. We all look to the one above for our strength renewed. When I help my brother, then I know that I plant the seed of friendship that will never die. We're better together, together as one." God bless you.
Thank you, Pastor. I want to introduce Pastor Derek Jenkins from Faith and Work Christian Church.
Reverend Rivera, Pastor Rivera, the NYPD, our commissioner, Chief Jaffe, my precinct inspector, Rhea, and all of you for taking time out tonight to come together. I want to take us back to Saturday, where the commissioner out of his department reported that during the protest, there were no arrests. That is a testament to unity within NYPD community. This is a great time of righteous protest. Righteous protest will never bring about violence, but only unity around those issues that spring up within in all of us. Concerns, hopes, dreams, disappointments. But in the end, we know that we can look to one God who is able to create us all and able to keep us all unified. And so I want to ask you all to be encouraged where you may feel discouraged tonight, because God is going to do greater things because we've chosen to come together as one. If I might ask you all to pray with me. In this time of great uncertainty, advances that reinforce that same uncertainty. But this awesome display of faith of varying forms and equal commitment to a process of love, love for all of God's people, a commitment to unity even when we lack understanding, and finally, a commitment to peace, a peace that surpasses all understanding. Jesus, we are depending on you to hold the fortress of peace and unity between us all, and to each of us, we are depending on each one of us for you to show another love, love out of us in the face of adversity, that we may be the leaders we all expect for us to be, we all deserve for us to be. And finally, all these things we do and we pray in the matchless name of Jesus, who is the Christ. Amen.
Amen.
Please welcome Rabbi Bob Kaplan from the Jewish Community Relations Council.
The prophets all agree. First, I'll say it in Hebrew and in English. Behold, how truly great it is when brothers and sisters dwell together in peace. That's the voice of the prophets. So today I had the opportunity of being amongst many other faith leaders, and the question was, what is the word, what is the role of the prophetic voice today? I want to share with you what I said, what I pray for. It's that we lend each other dignity. In a world where dignity is sort of being ripped out of much of our society by some, it is our responsibility, because the other role of a prophet is to be a partner with God. So as we partner with God, as we take on our role and responsibility, may God grace us, may He grant us the strength, the wisdom, and the ability to lend dignity to all, so that we shall truly say, Behold how truly great it is that brothers and sisters live together in peace.
Thank you. It's my pleasure to introduce Reverend T.K. Nakagaki of the Buddhist Council of New York.
Good evening, everyone, and my pleasure to be here with you. And although this is a very difficult time, but I feel very nice part for me, meaning I remember after 9/11, before New Yorkers all by themselves, but yet after that, everybody together, and now we have the same feeling that I have. I feel so. Everybody's together. Even yesterday, Washington Square, with the very last minute gathering, but yet everybody's gathered, and then bring in love, compassion together, and then that's what we can do. And that's in New York City, I believe. And so I really feel this is the energy that we really bring up from the New York to the over the country, the entire country, this country, also to the world. And with that, Buddhism always talking about interdependence, interconnectedness. And so I hope that you can feel the interconnected, as you're sitting here, but also as you meditate with me. Okay. So, so that's why I brought the bell, as you can expect. And so maybe if you don't mind, sit with your back straight. And then relax your body. We forgot to breathe when we had kind of so much stuff going on. So try to breathe in and out slowly and deeply. That's very common to all human beings. We breathe. All the animals also breathe. Everybody who are living on this earth breathe. And then breathe in, breathe out. So close your eyes. Relax your body. Slowly breathe out and then empty your stomach. And if you still have lungs, you can breathe from the lower stomach. And then breathe in slowly. And feel the energy coming to you. And as you breathe out, you can extend your loving kindness to all people. All your neighbors. Again, when you breathe in, hold the wisdom and compassion to yourself. So that you have enough energy to act. Peace to you all. Thank you.
Thank you, Reverend. Ladies and gentlemen, please give a warm welcome to Buddhist Annie Nikunin for a musical presentation.